killer.
To think that Miss Long and Cadosh were only a few feet away from him.
Indeed, Watson. Had Miss Long passed just a little closer to the victim and her assassin, or had the young Cadosh popped his head over the fence out of curiosity, the killer would most certainly already be behind bars.
That's some stroke of luck he had there.
I couldn't agree more, Watson. But his luck didn't end there, given the mutilations inflicted upon this poor woman. What must be considered above all is the killer's obvious wish to remove one and only one specific organ. His surgery pinpointed the exact spot, avoiding superfluous incisions. This suggests the man possesses at least a minimal anatomical knowledge.
Are you suggesting a doctor or a butcher?
Perhaps, but the possibilities are still too broad to conclude with any certainty. Now for the motive. Despite my almost complete lack of practical experience on the subject, I have a rather precise idea of the usefulness of a uterus and a vagina. Nonetheless, once they are separated from their usual envelope, I am more circumspect as to the uses one can make of them. What do you think, Watson? We need a board, Watson.
Do we use this one?
Money, quite simply.
Even if this motive seems incongruous, we're in no position to deny or affirm it until we know whether a market for human organs exists.
Holmes, what if it was cannibalism?
Even if the idea is unbearable, we can't ignore it as a possibility.
Perhaps it was intended as a study specimen.
I have little faith in that theory. Hardly anything was taken from the Bucks Row victim.
Black magic?
Watson, this line of investigation is far too vague. We don't have a single clue in support of such a motive. We can eliminate this hypothesis. Elementary. What emerges from these possible motives for having removed the uterus from the second victim is that they implied that the killer could have carried out the same thing on the Bucks Row victim, yet didn't. This brings us to a terrible conclusion. Our killer has evolved in the space of only a few days, and if that's the case, had he already struck before the first murder to which we attribute him? And if the killer strikes again, what atrocity awaits his next victim?
We have to stop him, Holmes.
We shall do our best. This recent business of jar filled with formalin and of the American doctor might be a lead. Watson, inquire among medical circles to ascertain if there is a black market for human organs. The chances are slim, but this must be pursued.
Very well. What about you, Holmes?
I will send word to Inspector Abeline regarding our recent conclusions. I should also like to become a gas man and pay a visit to Bluto at the Wasp's Nest.
Understood, Holmes. I think one of my old university colleagues who works at the London Hospital will be able to help me.
Oh, that's where we're going.
I shall write him a note at once. He should be able to see me during the day. Afterwards, shall we meet here?
Yes, Watson. See you later, and good luck.
I must get to the London Hospital, where my old university colleague works.
All right. Dr. Watson.
To the London Hospital, quick. My colleague agreed to meet me here in one of the London Hospital rooms reserved for students.
Ah, John, you're there already. Punctual as always. Tell me, you don't seem to be in good shape. Is it possible that your recent marriage is making you this morose?
Ah, you know me well, Andrew. No, it's a strange and terrible affair that concerns me. Have you read my note?
Yes, I admit that I was surprised. It just so happens that I, too, was asking questions about our morgue.
What do you think? Have you heard of any organ trafficking within?
No, John. No doubt there exists some exchange between colleagues. Not quite legal, of course, but nothing that can qualify as trafficking. Since the Anatomy Act of 1832, which permitted the use of unclaimed corpses for science, the black market trade was definitely halted. There are sufficient subjects available for all practitioners and students, of this I can confirm.
Well, organ trafficking as a lucrative trade is out of the question. Then what is troubling you with the morgue?
You are talking about trafficking organs. But I suspect there is trade in whole bodies.
What do you mean to say? Whole bodies are disappearing?
Well, it's confidential, but I know of your discretion and your friendship with the famous Sherlock Holmes. I can tell you that a few corpses have recently disappeared from the hospital morgue. Cadavers that were intended for dissection. That is to say, not claimed. Poor, unknown people. If a single corpse had disappeared, it might have been a bad joke. There are many students who pass through here. It's even a meeting spot. For the majority, they are here to work. A few come here in secret to practice. It also happens that instruments or organs go missing. Nothing alarming, but so many corpses. It's very troubling.
But the hospital doctors aren't doing anything?
No. That is to say, they would prefer not to call the police at this point. An investigation would no doubt result in the suspension of authorizations for the use of unclaimed corpses. Do you think that you could intercede on our behalf with Sherlock Holmes to clear up this situation?
Which corpses are missing?
Ah, I don't know exactly, but I can make an exact list if you would like to wait here for a few minutes. Feel free to look around the room while you wait. It'll bring back memories.
Thank you, Andrew. It's here that students come to carry out their experiments. This surgical instrument resembles a screwdriver. How amusing. It might come in handy. I will return it later. It's here that students come to carry out their experiments. These wheeled trolleys are very handy for laying out surgical instruments. This wheel won't roll despite all of the added grease. Curious, as Holmes would say.
So then he's the item for
a message. I'll be. Why the devil was it hidden here?
Evan Levin, 7 years old, son of Sarah and Jacob Levy. Hospitalized, 18 May. Syphilis advanced stages, possibly in. MMN subject, monitor carefully. The magnet's in the heart. Use the board. Okay.
An old prescription. Poor child, so young, yet terminally ill. Strange, someone scrawled something. Part of it is in Latin. These are instructions, it would seem. The last lesson must have been about the human heart. And for a class of beginners, I expect, as this diagram is rather rudimentary. An encyclopedia of anatomy. A page on the human heart is dog-eared. Let's see.
Numerous immunos. It's a picture of a heart of all this crap. This is music.
It's here that students come to carry out their experiments.
Okay, what else? Jeez. Anything here? Nothing.
It's here that students come to carry. The last lesson.
I already read that.
There is a heart in this jar. Based on its colouring, it hasn't been there long. And it looks like the drawing on the board. This jar contains two lids with combination locks.
Oh. Okay. Okay. So
Look, there was a bit of paper stuck between the two lids.
Okay. Number six, all right. So, red hand number two. Blue hand number eight.
Incredible. Wow. Someone has hidden a magnet in this heart. But to what end?
That took the magnet here. Model pupil. Okay.